Very glad to be able to introduce to you Michał Szymanowski. Who is here already for the second time for this workshop. And I heard him first in Korea, where he took second prize, should have been first, in the Daegu International Competition.
Chopin Competition.
And he has won a number of other awards as well, and is building a wonderful career. And we look forward to hearing what he has to say about the music.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bravo, very impressive. Do you understand English?
A little bit?
Yes. Do we need a translator? How old are you?
I'm 14 years old.
14 years old. I was always dreaming about Polonaise fantasy. I was always want to play it, but I always felt that I'm not ready. Now, in two weeks, I will turn 30, so I think I will be ready to to play it.
Yeah. 선생님도 늘 이 폴란드 펀트에서 치고 싶었는데 선생님도 기다려야 이거 이거는 이거 칠 준비는 아직 안 된 것 같아 그렇게 청숙한 곡이거든.
I find the Polonaise fantasy as one of the most demanding Chopin pieces, the most complicated, and actually I find that it's his best piece. It's really truly masterpiece, and I think
Chopin 곡 중에 굉장히 가장 성숙한 곡이고 공부해야 되고 이해해야 될 게 많기 때문에 그래서 선생님도 기다리는 중이라고.
It's very hard to make it as one piece, to connect all those fragments, to create a form.
크게 하나로 만드는 게 어렵다고 다 이렇게 안 그럼 다 쪼개지거든.
It's, I think it's similar with most of big pieces by Chopin, like late pieces like Barcarolle, like Fourth Ballade, like Polonaise Fantasy, because there are different ideas, different fragments, and to create one story, we need to really think how to make it one, not just a little fragments, but how to create one piece, one story, which is of course your story. Everybody has to play differently because we are different human beings, and everybody can play different within style, but it has to be our story. You can't play like your teacher, like Zimmermann, like Pollini. No, you have to find your own Polonaise fantasy, and this is, I think, the most difficult, but I think you play very well, and generally I like it very much. There are, of course, no details which we will talk about to make it even better, but congratulations, because you are 14. It's, you start very early. Yeah, so let's start. So tell me, what do you think about the beginning of the piece? What is it? Can you describe me? What do you think? I think this is improvisation. This is Polonaise fantasy. And of course, there's lots of places where the Polonaise is very, we can hear it and this rhythm. But I think at the beginning, there is no Polonaise. There is fantasy. There is improvisation. I think you know that Chopin was a great improviser. He was famous. Just he sit on the piano and start to play.
Okay, for that. Yeah, okay. Chopin이 즉흥적인 거를 본래 굉장히 잘하는 사람이었지? Okay.
Even some of his pieces are truly improvisation, like literally.
이미 곡이 써 있지만 거의 즉흥적인 거 같은 그 상태로 작곡이 된 게 많아.
Like a prelude in C sharp minor. Do you know?
Prelude C sharp minor 뭔지 알아? Di ra ra
ra ri ra ra ra. Do you know it? It's improvisation. Chopin was improvising it, and he then wants to write it down.
Yeah.
And he actually really struggled with writing it, because improvisation is something you create now. And writing it down, it was very hard for him, because then he didn't want maybe this, maybe that one. When he improvised, he just can play every time differently. And when he had to write it down, it was very hard work for him. So, at the beginning, it's very, very important to have this feeling of improvisation. Of course, you have to be prepared and you have to play the right notes. But you have to give this impression that some idea is coming to you and you start to play like... Yeah. You're telling us a story, yeah? I'll try. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. I think, yes, I think you've got the idea of improvisation. There are just two things we can talk about. Try to, with those little notes, yes, in piano, they are kind of the same as the chord. They are like harmonics. Mm. So don't try to play it louder than the chord. It should be like, when we have this chord. So those notes are like within the chord. Yeah? No. Sometimes it was just too big. Yeah. Try to find this kind of resonance in the piano. Well, this is very unequal. It's hard to show it. Yeah? You have to just try it. Especially in piano, it's very important. Uh huh. No, but with chord, of course. Yes, exactly. Yes. Yeah, a little shiny. We have to be careful, especially in this register. Because if you play too loud here, it just will kill all these harmonics, yes? So be careful here and in here. Make a little shiny. Then the chord is not flat. The piano sounds really open. The sound is very nice. Yes, but just think about it. Yeah, we don't have to play it now. Yes, and after this improvisation part, kind of there is the start of the piece. The piece really starts. So we have kind of action. And start to really, really follow the music, really phrase and don't stop. Because I think you stop too much. You know? And continue, okay? So try not to stop here. Can we try from here? Maybe a little bit of more. Yes, because this is melody. I want to really have it really clear. Otherwise, we cannot hear the melody. Yes, please continue. Yes. Let's start one more time. So we have a crescendo, yeah? Continuously we have crescendo until there. So please don't stop. Try to really connect it. This is really one big line, yeah? After this improvisation, we start to really play, okay? Try. Okay, but be careful. This is resolution. Mm. Yeah? Because you dominant and so. Be careful. Every time where there is resolution, we have to listen to it. Yeah? Or maybe from here? Okay, no, not bad, but also not. This is also resolution. Yeah. And try to make it as smooth as possible. Like some, I don't know, cello. Very legato and very, very, very smooth. Can we try? can I have some little technical suggestion? You know, you play very nice. I and get the ideas very quickly. Just maybe make it a little more flat, because if you have fingers like that, it's sometimes it's hard to play legato. With this, maybe it's better for Haydn or for Mozart. Yeah, but if you want to play legato, sometimes to really feel the keys. Don't worry. Yeah, it's not a beast which will. Yeah, but try slower. Listen, this is really. Do you know what is it? Do you know? The Neapolitan chord. Do you know? No. Harmonically. It's always for us. It's nothing special, but for them in Chopin's time, it was something special, and we have to kind of. Got. Just listen to it and pay attention. Yeah. Okay, but let's continue. And not too fast. Yeah. A tempo giusto. Yeah? And always until the long. Okay. Thank you very much. Yes, it's very, very nice. In general, it's everything is okay. Just try to hear the melody every time, because sometimes your melody is going under left hand. Yeah, so always try to listen to it, and never rush on triples. Triples are easy to kind of make a slave. Yeah, every time. Yeah? Then we might think there are two 16 notes and one 8 note or opposite. But every time it has to be really synced. Yeah, so be careful with left hands. So it's never over the right hand. Yeah, the melody is very, very important. Yes, those triples. And there are certain places where we really need legato, like here. But sometimes it's just not enough. Especially when there is a chromatism, yeah? Requires even more legato, more connecting things. Yeah? Can we play once again and try to control your right hand? And then next phrase. This is the Polonaise. I mean, you also have it very clear. So don't play too fast because then it's very hard. So right hand is very, very smooth, very soft, and the left hand like in a very good orchestra, the wind players. They play very really soft, but really, very very well articulated. Yeah, in better orchestra they can't play that like that. Try. Yes, exactly. So please remember about that, and when you practice, always try to listen to the melody, and so it's never, And then we have this fragment. Second time maybe a little different, yeah, because you played two times exactly the same. There is some reason why he repeated, yeah, so try to find an answer why he want you to play second time. Maybe a little bit of left hand. Kind of question mark. Huh? Maybe can we try from here? And with the left hand, very, very smooth. Like in sonata, yeah? It's kind of very, very nice atmosphere, he seems to be very happy here. Yeah, don't you think? There is no pain, no, everything is like in America.
Yeah.
Yeah, so very smooth. Mm-hmm. Very pastoral. Huh? Yes, very nice. Bravo. I wouldn't do crescendo here. I think it's written diminuendo, and it sounds better when it's diminuendo, especially when we go down. If you make crescendo, it start to be big. And I think kind of longer pedals can be very helpful here. Just listen to you, because otherwise it's a little like a wind, yeah? Can you try from here, for example? Or what you want. This is kind of, make it also very smooth. Yeah, because this is one harmony. You don't need to, you know, change pedal every bar, but just have very, very little pedal and listen to yourself. And then maybe you will just need one or two pedals, but just very, very little. Yeah? Because the harmony is just one, so we can do it. Even less. Just. I make a little crescendo while we go up. And with bass, yeah? So when you reach bass, and then take pedal and. Yeah, but you have to articulate it. Yes, much better. Do you prefer it? Do you like it? Yeah, so the same with similar fragments, yeah? Then there are not so... Okay, one more time and continue. But please don't stop here. We just go and you have to, you know, drive into it. Don't stop before the climax. Yeah? The same way. Yes, go. Yes. Yeah. Even more, don't stop. And more. Yeah. The same. And diminuendo. Yes, so if you make this crescendo and reach this climax, then you have space for making diminuendo and play as it's written. Otherwise, you have to make crescendo because then you will disappear. Yeah. So please, don't give up and really reach this. Yeah, and then we go here. Yeah. Very shiny. And don't stop. Why will you do it? This is continuation. Don't stop here. Something changed here? No, so why you stop? Please. This is a kind of ornament, yes? Like a little harp. And then the melody starts. So don't change pedal. Or just a little bit, yeah? Yeah? And don't stop, please. Okay, the left hand is too much. Oh, yeah. Yeah? Very discreet. Right hand. So try to make it on diminuendo. Making crescendo here doesn't sound so well. Always be careful when we go down with making crescendo, especially on such a fast passages, doesn't sound very well. So just be careful here, okay? Yeah. Melody. I can hear melody. Okay, because the time is good. So please remember about every time we really need this melody, and then just adjust left hand to it. So it's never, you know, to too heavy and yeah. Okay, can we just switch for the middle section? Yeah. Try to create really atmosphere like from different world. It's very similar to the fantasy. Yes. Do you know Polish Chopin's fantasy? Do you know this one? It's like you are alone in a big cathedral, there is nobody there, and you start to pray. This is something, you know, this kind of atmosphere, or speaking to God. Yeah? So this is really very pure. Yeah? So try to from here. Yeah? You are alone. Yeah? Bravo. But even here, we need melody, yeah? Just a little bit, yeah? Melody. If I can suggest you something, we need different type of articulation for the melody. Otherwise, it's very hard to have it. Yeah. So it's more kind of. If you articulate it differently, then we have different type of sound, and it's easier to have this polyphonic lines. Otherwise, it's, if you play like maybe more articulated, okay, better projection, yeah? Yeah. Can you start from here? Very nice. Not here. Every legato. Also piano. To understand the harmony, yeah? No? Not so short. Pausa. No. Too early. Just listen to this. It's really scary because we don't know where we are. And this is very sad. Huh? It was not real. It was a dream. and he realized that where he is now. And this is really sad. We are not in America. He was in Poland, but there was no Poland. Yeah, so he discovered. Thank you. It was really nice. I really like it. You really create this kind of atmosphere, and it was really nice. Just don't try not to show all those different things, as like without bars. Just one trill, just change. But you are a very good student. You show. I know that now we have this trill, and now we have this trill, and now we have this. But musically, it's the same. It's the same harmony, and we just go until here. Yeah. So try to connect it. But thank you very much. It was really nice. Bravo. I have to say I really like your performance. It was dramatic and at the same time very solid. And as I said, I remember you from last year, and I like it very much. The thing which maybe I like less is some kind of rubatos which you make. Of course, in terms of ideas of Schubert is a romantic composer, but in terms of style and kind of playing no rubato, it's much closer to the classical composers. So, for example, in the second when you start second theme, I don't like that. For me, it was a little too much, and I think. Then we kind of don't believe you, I would say, because the thing which makes the biggest impression on people are facts. If you just say something which is terrible or very, scary, for example, it's just very good to just say it, because it's just very scary. And if you just start to say, oh, you know, it's so scary, you know, I saw something, people don't believe that. Yeah, I remember there was a kind of a book about Nazi murders, and of course there was lots of book with lots of comments, and there was just a little book which was just talking about facts, and it was the most scary book about it, because there was no emotion. It was just showing what just happened. And I think we can, it's the same, if you just play and this is something scary, if you just play it, it will make this impression. And if you start to add your own, kind of, I have the feeling that it makes less impression. Huh? So it's maybe sometimes better to be a little maybe more simple, and not to make those kind of rubatos. Yeah? But let's start from the beginning. Because at the beginning, I sometimes lose this kind of dramatism, which at the beginning was very good. But in some places, you just kind of give up. I know that I have the feeling that you don't want to play too loud, which is also good. But remember about this intensity. This is really, really kind of dramatic piece. Yeah, so let's try. Can you try even more piano? Yes. Very good. At the same tempo. Not rush. Okay, but don't rush. It's the same tempo. Yeah, I just don't know why you after this you play. Like kind of answer. Do you want to make an answer here? I'm not convinced.
I tried to, the first chord is very, I want to make develop. So that's why
I know.
But
I don't think this is an answer. Okay. I think that until this, it's kind of one character. I think it's too early for echo.
Okay.
Yeah? I don't want to, press on you. It just doesn't sound so good.
Okay.
I think this also, also second, I know you don't play, of course you don't want to play like that, but if you release too much, we lose this intensity here. Yeah, tom, pom, just the same. If you play too long, it's not good, of course, yeah, but it's also, yeah. Tom, pom, let's go. Too much. Don't make accent. Yeah. Exactly the same. Pom, pom. Not too short. I think it's too short. Let's try to make it even more piano. Over. Of course, you know, it's very. So, kind of intensity also in piano, which is, of course, more harder. Yeah? But all of you. Yeah, so try to find the most comfortable position. So be very, very close. And just move as less as possible, just to have this position. Because if you move too much, it starts to be too loud. Yeah? Don't keep it, don't keep this. Don't keep it, yeah? Because it makes your hand stick, yeah? Yeah, feel relaxed. Yeah, opposite of what I just said about the Chopin, about this flat. Here we need. Yes, it's not comfortable, but you have to. Yeah, I will practice it a lot. It's because left hand make the intensity in this kind of dramatic. Without left hand, right hand is not so such a no dramatic. Hmm? Yeah, from here, yeah, can maybe both hands. But remember also about when you finish. I don't know where is the ending of this note. Very precise. Also sometimes you just when you finish, it's also very very romantic. Sometimes we need very precise beginning of the note and the end of the note. Yeah, because I don't know where it here. So very, very clear, yeah? Tiro, papa, tiro, 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 papa, tiro. Yeah, one more time. No butter. Mm. Yeah, so it's very clear. Yes. But from here, not from here, but from here. This is pianissimo, yeah? So different, maybe different color. So together, hand together with pedal. Yeah. So then it's very precise. Otherwise, it's. Yeah. We lose this intensity because, yeah, tom, bom. Like we have even, maybe a little longer, tim. No, and now you have to change your mood. People need this time and you also need this time. Take a brief before. Completely different, completely different mood. Okay, different mood, but the same tempo. Yeah, this is very hard. Bel legato. So, of course, middle voice is much less than it. You got. It's impossible to play this legato, so we need to make it very. So also be very, very close, very close. Sometimes play without it. This I don't like. But very simple, very simple. It's very beautiful. Yeah? No, beautiful girl doesn't need to have makeup. Yeah? She's just beautiful. If she starts to, you know, too much is, you know, also not very nice. Yeah? Here also Miss Legato. The thing which helps us with legato is also phrasing. Sometimes when it's impossible to play legato, we kind of pretend we play legato with phrasing. Yeah? So this is very helpful. If you just play ta 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 ta, there is no legato. I have never played this, so I'm just focused on this. But let's try from here. I think we have to start it from toko 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 to without ta 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 pa 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 pa, yeah, like new beginning, yeah. Really listen to half notes for all long notes, yeah, because you are forgetting about this. Yeah, all long notes, just really when you practice. You can play double time, I would say. To check if you still listen to this long note, okay? And don't be afraid, there's just piano. If you start too less, there is no space for pianissimo. And it's much harder with this left hand, yeah? It's also very interesting and it's nice to have it clear. And if you just play too pianissimo, everything is just not hearable. Yeah, but very nice. Yeah. So let's continue. Maybe let's connect it. Yeah. Thank you. forte. È fortissima. But look. There's a little accent. Yeah. So try to listen to those different registers here. Of course, tir. This accent, just we can play it a little longer. Try to listen. This register, this, like in the orchestra, there are flute with oboe and clarinet with fagot, and different heat. This is very typical for some symphonies and some orchestral works. Like in Beethoven's symphonies. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Let's try from here. Yeah, and never, you know, always practice this. Listen to all those lines. Yeah? But don't prepare. This is finished. Yeah. So don't be. Finish this. No, yeah, the same thing. Take pedal together with hands. Otherwise, we don't know. Yeah. So. No. But pianos until the end, and just two chords are fortissimo. Not earlier. Yeah. Try to make it as it's written. When you practice, play until the end and stop. And listen, if I'm playing piano or making crescendo. Yeah, so really, really piano. And then, tot-tom. This is the way how to practice it. Pum-pum. Otherwise, it's impossible to make it. You have to really stop and listen. Otherwise, you don't know if you make it or don't. Yeah, yeah, but please continue. Same tempo, taka taka ta pa 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 pa. But right hand is not equal. Be careful there. Really legatissimo. Especially here. But right hand. Try. but it's opposite. This is pianissimo, and before it was piano. Yeah. So don't try to. It's misterioso. It's true, but it has to be also clear. Otherwise, there is some kind of mess, and we don't get it. Yeah. Please practice this, because it's really. I know it's not easy. I think we don't need to play it staccato. Just very, very perfectly. Also, find very comfortable position. Not move your hand too much. Just please practice it later, okay? So maybe you can continue. Let's start from here. Piano, and now pianissimo. Five minutes. Maybe a little bit of second movement. Okay, we have just little time. Generally, I like it. The atmosphere is nice. Just little details. Yeah. There is really big surprise here. You want E flat major again. And what is it? This is big difference. And I thought this is not special for you. But I think this we should show it. This is really big surprise. Yeah. This is now. So remember about that, and really listen to long, nice. Because the melody continues. Yeah. Otherwise, it starts again. Yeah. Let's try one more time. And remember, first time is piano, second is pianissimo. If you start too little, then there is no space for second time. Okay. No. Yes, very clear. Yeah. even more. The different sound. Different type of sound, really. The Spanish. Don't rush, the same tempo. That's the rest is very delicate. I'm afraid we have to finish. Yes, but it was really nice working with you. You are very talented and I like it very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bravo. You have great technical ability. It's not hard for you in this etude? It's very easy?
It is difficult.
I can't see. Do you know what is the title of this etude? A title, because each etude has kind of name, a title. There's Eroica. You know, or you don't
about a war.
Yeah, Appassionata. This is the title. Yeah. So I have the feeling that you play, you know, very fast and loud, but it's not Appassionata.
You mean she liked the Appassionata feelings? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I didn't feel kind of tension and dramatism. Although it was very fast and very, you know, it was fortissimo, it didn't make impression on me. I was not. Don't make me feel appassionato. Huh? So there's a certain difference between, you know, forte. We can play forte without, you know, intensity and intensivity and tension. Sometimes in piano we can have really tension. So this is which I lack here. This kind of really, really tremendous appassionato and those kind of emotional feelings. So it's not question of tempo, it's not question of loudness, it's question of... Yeah? Sometimes, very often, you lose bass. When you take pedal, it was always after bass, not before bass. So there was lots of passages without basement. It's like a human without legs or house without basement. Yeah, we need, for the harmony, we need good bass. And bass was always after, and you didn't really listen to it, yeah? We don't have full harmony when there's no bass. There's a... It's not so strong. Yeah? The piano doesn't sound without bass. Because this is where the harmonic starts. We really need this basement for the tension and the sound, everything actually. Yeah, so really listen if you get this basement. Yeah, so generally speaking, I like it very much. We just, you know, I have to say something to make it even better. Yeah, so can we try? And try to find this kind of tension, this... Thank you. It's not bad. Just let's make the phrasing more clear. Yes? So we have the opening. And it's just it. Yes? Second time. So try to really make us understand it. Yeah? So every time there's more, it's longer. First time is just one bar, yeah? Second time we have two bars, even three bars. Fourth time we have four bars. So I didn't get it when you play, yeah? So let's try. Okay, but don't hit it. Yeah? This is one melody. No? It's like not from this phrase. I know it's because of technical reason, but try to connect them. Prepare it with your elbow. Yes. Yeah, I remember this is also a melody. Not. I know it's a 16 note, but this is melody. Torom, tirom, not torom, tirom. So also listen to it. Mm-hmm. Much better now. Now you need some time, so it makes it a little slower, but it's more, you know, more intensity. I would start this even softer. After this, it's like you know, a skeleton. No, like do you know Dance Macabre by Liszt? But this is like very scary, this skeleton is yeah, so No, play Alanin. You have to have it. Even more. No, yes, but this is fortissimo. This is kind of climax here. But you play it as it's easy going.
Yeah.
I think it's too easy for you.
So
you don't care. This is really something. Yeah, yes, please make also crescendo with left hand. Don't make it so flat. Can you play just left hand for me? Yes, especially the second sixth. Really, really play it. We need it. I want to hear it. Yeah. Otherwise, there's just something. And this is what makes it so dramatic. Yeah. Try it, just left hand, yes? Yeah, but let's try to make it maybe more. Make crescendo. Don't let it so flat. Yeah. Yes, and then with right hand. Fortissimo. No. Why so less? We can play less, but don't lose this tension.
Yeah.
Thank you. with both. No, where is pausa? Where is pausa? I want to hear this rest. No, the same before, here. We need to hear this. Yum, ta-dam! Otherwise, tam, pa-pam. This is very, very expressive. It's even a fermata on this. So don't forget, you know, silence is very powerful. Both when we play some soft, you know. It's really speaking much, I think it's, you know, speaking even more than those five pages of lots of passages. Just little pausa. Because we are expecting the resolution. Ba-bam! Yeah? Otherwise, there is no tension. But don't wait too much, as Daniel, waiting in the door. Yeah. Yeah. But much better now. Much better now. It's start to.
Oh, I see. I
yeah. But listen to your teacher. He wrote very good thing. Yeah. Not. Yes. It's also have time. If play. There's no tension. Bum, bum. Dom, bum. I want to hear it. Very important. Okay. But some of the notes are less important. Yeah, there is resolution. For example, here. So not play. We have phrases, yes, here. Yeah, actually, I think it starts from the second beat, not yeah, because it was the end of this. Ram, pam, pa bam. Yeah, so it started from here, not from here. So we need to really underline this. Tim, pam, pa bam. Yeah, but also I know you want to show this left hand, but don't forget about this. Also, left hand is also important. Yeah, you can show left hand, of course, no problem. But don't forget about right hand. Huh? They should be both, not just left, and we forget about right. Yeah. Yes, please. Continue from here. Okay, and play just right, left hand for me. This. Yes, you need to practice to have very strong thumb. Yeah. So if you play very 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 hard, it's hard to have it. This is like trumpets. Ba bam. So of course, bass very tenuto. Yeah, this shouldn't be smaller than bass. Yeah, so judge how much bass you want. Because too big bass will kill this. It will be. Yeah, but we need this. So don't rush here. Ba-bam. We need time. Yeah, do you understand? Wonderful. Okay, so let's continue. The same. I don't understand harmony. I just too much left hand, right hand. This is harmony. This is not just bam bam. Yeah. Can you play slower? I'm sorry. Yeah. Play it slow, please. Yes. So it's not the same. It's not one bar pattern. Yes. It's there are four different chords. Pa-pam, ti-ton, ti-ton, ti-ton. They are different. So listen to it. It's not so simple. Yeah. One more time. No. How we call it?
Pickups.
Yeah. We need this bass. Otherwise, it's.
The bass is quiet.
Wait a second. What's so difficult here? Just one pedal, slowly release. Press and slowly release. Just one. Try. No, but you just stay with the very deep. But make kind of diminuendo. Yes, exactly. Release. So. It will make all the things we need. Otherwise, you need to change, Pada. And we don't have time for that. Yeah? Too late. Already here, we have to be without to presses on bass. Let's try with just left hand. Yes, you have to just practice it. So in the second half of the bar, on the here, you need to start to release pedal. Yeah. It was very, very slowly, very slowly. Yes. And try with right hand now. Do you understand it? Do you understand? Yeah, I know it's maybe now it's too less time to do it, but it will help you. Then you have time to catch bass. Yeah, and. It will be also legato, but you have to also connect with your fingers. But I will not resolve the problem. Okay, but please. Thank you. Forte, this is Forte. you're on vacation in Hawaii, no? No. It's appassionato. Do you know what appassionato means? Also take time. Listen to it. Yeah. So don't make diminuendo here. It starts from nothing. Yeah. Maybe one of the last passages. What are you doing? I try to play on one pedal. This is one harmony. Just try. I like it more. And you? Yeah, but maybe a little earlier, just to have it. So really, listen to this pause. Yeah. Even more. Yararam. We really have to be interrupted. But please start from here. Thank you very much. And remember about this appassionato.
Thank you very much.